This is a form in a model-driven app. So is this, and so is this. A form is what the user sees when they open a record in your app, and you get to design the layout that they're going to see to give them a really good experience. In this video, I'm going to show you how you create and edit forms in model-driven apps. Let's start with the out-of-the-box contact form. Get familiar with what's on the screen so that when we go behind the scenes for our editing experience, you know what's what and where all of these pieces come from. So first concept we have here is a tab. We've got the summary tab and the details tab. This allows you to have lots of different tabs across the top, which is a much better user experience than trying to pack too much onto the screen and people have to scroll down when they're looking for things in your app. On each tab, you have columns with sections in them. This one is actually a three column, but the third column there is blank. This one is also a three column tab, but that's been used up a little bit better. And then each of these rectangular boxes in here is called a section. A section has a heading in it, which you can choose to have or not. And then inside each section, we've also got table columns or those attributes that are on the table. So those are the pieces essentially that are making up the form. Let's go in and put one together. As always, we are working in make.powerapps.com, and you should have created a solution for your model-driven app. Check out my other video if you don't know how to do that. I'm going to click through into the solution where I've created my app previously, and I'm going to go in and find the table that I want to be working with, in this case, contact. So the forms belong to tables. We're always going into the table to find the form to edit. So I'm going to scroll down here, choose my contact table, and then in the menu across the top here, I'm going to go across to the section labeled forms. Now there are some different types of forms in here. This video is focusing on the main form, which is what we looked at the start. Now I can go in here and say add form and create a new main form from scratch. But what I'm going to do is go into the existing main form here called contact and clone it, save as, so that I can create a copy and edit it. Top tip here, if you do want to edit those out of the box forms, this is the way to do it. Don't go and change them. You always want to keep those original ones in there. Always do this clone process so that you've got a copy of the original to go back to. So I'm in my editor now, and the first thing I'm going to do is exactly that. I'm going to go and save as and give this another name. We'll just call this one Contact LC and save that. So hopefully you can see here that this is pretty much the same thing we were looking at before when we looked at our contact, but the back end version of building it. We've got our fields columns down the side here. We've got the two tabs, summary and details, just as we saw here before, summary and details. So nice WYSIWYG editing experience. We start with the tree view down the side here, which gives us the structure of the different pieces on the form. So we've got a header, which allows us to put things up in the top and highlight them. We can have up to four columns from the table in there. We've got the tabs here, so you can see we've got the summary tab and the details tab, and there's also a footer. I tend not to work in the tree view, I tend to come over here. So the things that we're really working with here are the components. This is where we're going to find tabs and sections and some other kind of more advanced things that we can get into, and then our table columns that we want to drag across. Let's start by adding a tab, and you'll see that my choices here are that I can set this up as a 1, 2, or 3 column tab. I'm going to pop a 2 column tab in here as a starting point, and you'll see that it gives me a new tab in here, very helpfully called new tab, but we want to give it a better name than that. So we can go over here and change the label. Let's say I'm creating this tab because I want to put in additional contact details and contact preferences for the person. So I'm going to give this one a label, which is contact details. And then we can also give it a schema name. So that's the label that will appear on there. You'll see if I click away from that, it will change straight away. Now we've also got formatting options in here. So you'll see that this is a 2-column tab. I can change that to be 1 column or 3 columns if I want to at any point. And I can also change the width. So let's say I wanted to make that first column a little bit wider and the next one a little bit narrower, then I can do that, and you'll see that that adjusts on the screen accordingly there. I can also move the order of the tabs around. So let's say I wanted that one to be at the end. I can actually click on the tab here and just drag that with my mouse, and you'll see as I move things around the screen, just be aware, see how it's giving me a little purple thing there versus if I try to put it somewhere that's not valid, I get that little red circle. So the whole drag and drop experience here, just look out for when it lets you, you know, it gives you a little purple flag to say that you're doing something that's valid, so we can change the order of those things. The next thing we want to look at is the sections, and just be aware of what you're clicking on here, because with tabs and sections, it's very easy to get confused if you're working quickly or you're not paying attention. So here I've clicked on the whole tab, which is a two column tab with two sections in it. If I click here, you'll see my purple highlight is now just on that section. The properties on the right have changed. So this is new section. This doesn't have much in it. So let's give this one a label. And I like to use caps here because this just makes it feel a little bit more like a heading on the screen. So let's call this postal address. Now the section itself can also have formatting on it. So if we go in here, you'll see that I can apply 1, 2, 3, or 4 columns to my section. So you could actually get effectively 12 columns of data across the screen. I would strongly advise against doing that because you could have three, like a tab with three sections, and then each of those sections could have four columns in it. Just always bear in mind good user experience here, not how much can you pack on the screen. But if you have a legitimate reason for doing that, then you can actually do that. So we've got our postal address section in there, and I'm going to now start to bring across my table columns. Now, just be aware of the terminology here. We've got columns within the tab. We can have columns within the section. When we use that version of the word columns, we're actually meaning just like, you know, columns in the layout. But we also work with table columns, those fields, attributes, columns that you set up on your table, first name, last name, email address, those kinds of things. So we're going to start talking about those now. So I'm going to switch across here into this section, and I will see a list of all of the table columns that are available to me on the contact table, which is what I'm working with here. Now I can just scroll through this whole list and find the one that I want. When you're working with something like this that has a lot of different columns in it, it can be easier to actually start typing in here. So let's say I start typing address. Still got my caps lock on, but that won't matter. We'll take that off. Then what will happen is on the list, it will filter by what I'm typing in. And if I can't find something there, then what we need to do is make sure that this box is unchecked. So this is showing unused table columns. This won't show me anything if it's already on the form to protect me against duplicating things on the form. But if I'm looking for something that's there and I legitimately actually do want to duplicate that, then make sure to uncheck that box and you will get all of the options in there. So what I'm going to do now is put in, for instance, address 2, because I want to bring in a postal address, so I can go in here and filter that down a little bit more. And then I want to bring these across into my section here. So again, this is a drag and drop experience. I'm just going to click on that and drag it in and wait until, again, I've got something that's nicely purple highlighted so that I'm putting it in a legitimate place. There we go. We've got street line 1, street line 2, city, state, and we'll grab the postcode here. Now, if you want to move the order of any of these things around, you can do that too. So we can go in here and shuffle the order of those things if it goes around the other way. If at any point you do something that you don't like the look of, undo. We can always do that to switch it back again. So if you're desire is to just change something on the form. Let's say you've got an out-of-the-box form and you just want to move something around. It's really this simple. You can just come in and change the order of it with a drag and drop and then save and publish. Stick around till the end and I'll show you how we do that. Now, the other thing you can do here is to change the labels of these columns on the form. Just be careful about doing this because those table columns have those labels that were set up for them at the start. But if for some reason on the form you want it to display differently, then you've got the option to do that here. It can get a little bit confusing if they're labeled a certain way on the form and then in your data schema underneath they've actually got different names. But if you're aware of that and you can work with that, then this is something you can do. The other thing to be aware of is that you're building on a fully responsive interface here, which means that you can't actually set a fixed column width for how much space those labels take up. So you'll see there that they're doing a wraparound thing. This is an instance where you could go in and change those labels behind the scenes, but you don't want to change everything to be like zip zip, zip, because then you've got three different addresses with zip. So I'm going to leave those as they are, but just change them on the form here. So I can go over here and click on the label, and I'm just going to take this one back to be called postal code, because in my part of the world, that's the language that we use. In the address two here, I'm going to go through and make that one to be just state. And let me just fast forward while I tidy up the rest of these labels here. Let's say I want to use this other part of my form now to bring in the contact preferences, things like whether they allow bulk email, things like that. Now that's already on the form, but I want to put it in a different place. So we're going across here to the details form. You'll see that there is already a section there called contact preferences, but I want to move it. So what I can do here is select this whole section. Now just be careful, what I've done there is select one column. Watch where my purple highlight is. I want to select the whole section. And with that selected, I'm going to drag that and hover over the top of where I want it to be. And that will automatically take me there. And now I can move this. And I can put this, again, I've got a nice valid purple highlight there, and I can put it in. Now you'll see there was also already another blank new section there ready for me to use. I don't really want that anymore because I put that in, so I can go in here and delete. So any component that you want to delete from the form, you highlight it and you click that delete button and that's gone. Let's say fax is something that I don't use or care for, I can click on that and I can delete that there. So always just watch those purple highlights and where you are for moving things around and deleting things. So let's add another section to the form now. When we created our tab, it gave us those two sections to start with, but let's say I want to add another one in here and get this experience where we've got, for instance, you know, different blocks on the screen like this, where we've got personal and personal notes. That's another section on the form there. So I go back over here and I'm going to add a one column section. When I click on that, it's going to put it where I was previously highlighted. So I had that contact preferences highlighted, it's put it there. Actually, I don't want it there, so I can just pick it up and drag it, and I could put it, you know, above postal address if I wanted to, or I can just put it here. So again, wherever that purple arrow is where it's going to land. And this one, I'm going to go back into my columns here, and I'm going to add some other things in here. So let's say I wanted to bring in some information about the primary contact. So I can bring that one in here, and then we can give that section a name as well, or we could actually just leave it blank. So let's say we want to say this one doesn't need a name. We can leave it as new section and just say hide the label or give it a name, and then that will actually hide it from there and we don't have anything on the form. So the other thing we can do is to bring columns from the table into the header. So things that we want to be persistent up on the top of the form to see all of the time. So I can click in that section of the form and do the same thing, search for the column that I want. Let's say I want to bring the person's job title in here. Then I can search for that. Now it's not there. You know why, don't you? Because it's already on the form. I need to uncheck that box and then I'll find it. I can drag that up to the header there and there it is. And I can also just move the order of that around in the same way that we moved the order of the tabs earlier. If I need a new table column here, then I can also do that. So we can go in and click new table column. This is really convenient if there's something you've forgotten to add along the way. It will actually add it into your table to be used everywhere else. It's not exclusive to this form. The only limitation here is that you don't have all of the data types available to you. I've got another video that shows you all of the data types and creating columns if you want to check that one out. In particular, things like choice and choices aren't available to you here, but let's say we wanted to add the person's age and that was just a whole number, we can do that here. So let's add that one in, and the minimum value there is going to be 0 and the maximum value might be, you know, 120. And we put done, and let's say we want to add that one into the header as well, then we can go ahead and do that. All right, I think our form is looking pretty good now, so we're going to go ahead and save. And when that's done, we're going to publish. One other thing you want to do here is have a look at the form settings. This allows you to set up security roles for who will be able to view this form. So you might be creating something here where you want different forms for different users within your organization. That's something you can do here. And you can also set the form order so that there's a default of what's going to happen inside here. So security roles, we can make it available to everyone or select specific security roles from the list. And then the form order, we can go in and say which one is going to come up first. So let's say now that I've done this contact LC and I want to move that one up first, I can move that to be at the top of the list and then save and publish my changes. Now, the next thing we want to do, because we've created a new form, is make sure that this form is now part of our model-driven app. If you're just editing an existing form, you don't need to do that, but make sure you do this step if you've created a new form. So I'm going to use the back button here to go back into my solution and to find my model-driven app and make sure that this form is part of that app. I've got one app inside this solution, so I'm going to click there on apps. I'm going to click in to edit my app, and then I'm going to find the table that I was just editing, which is contact, and I've got forms here. Now you'll see this one is set to all. So in my app, everything is being added in there. If you haven't got that, if you've got something selected in here, make sure you go in and check the box of the form that you've just created, save and publish that as well. And then when you go back into your model-driven app, give this thing a hard refresh to make sure that it's picked up all of those good things you've just created and published. I will see that my form contact LC is now the one that comes up. You can always use this little drop down here to switch back and forth to the other forms, and we can see my brand new contact details tab that I added in there with all of those pieces there. But that's not all there is to forms. We've covered all of the basics here, but you might have noticed that when we were in this component section here, we've covered tabs and sections, but look, there's a whole lot of other goodness there. Next thing I want to show you is subgrids, where you can bring in data from related entities and show it here. So if you're working with accounts and you want to see a list of contacts, so come and check out the next video where I show you all about subgrids, how to use them and how to get them on your forms. I'll see you there.